everyone, and welcome to the 2014 induction ceremony of the Oak Tree Chapter of the National Honor Society. I'm RJ Hartwell, and I'm the advisor of the Oak Tree Chapter of National Honor Society. Since its inception in 1921, National Honor Society has been a way for secondary schools and their principal to recognize outstanding scholarship, leadership, service, and character. We would like to congratulate all of you for your part in encouraging and supporting the accomplishments of tonight's inductees. At this time, I would like to introduce Mrs. Champlain to say the Pledge of Allegiance, followed by Mr. Kilmer, our principal, to provide some introductory remarks.
For supporting your children, this has been an effort, not only of theirs, but of yours. Schools work in concert with the communities to educate. It takes a village, and your great support has helped them reach such incredible feats. You know, as a principal, I look at these incredible young men and women, not only as an educator, but as a father. When I bring my 8-year-old and 7-year-old to numerous events, I see in their eyes admiration. I see in their eyes excitement based on what they see your children do on a daily basis. So I'm not only honored to be their principal, but I'm also honored to live in a community where my children get to observe such incredible role models, such as these young men and women. So I congratulate you all on your great work so far, and I can't wait to see what is yet to come. So congratulations.
Scholarship means a commitment to learning. It's a student willingness to spend hours in reading and studying, knowing the lasting benefits of a cultivated mind. We should continue to learn, even when formal education has ended, for we continue to gain knowledge our whole lives. Scholarship is one great element in life, which leads to the highest success, and it can be acquired in only one way, through diligence and effort. Learning furnishes the lamp by which we read the past and the light that illuminates the future. Candidates have to charge to continually expand their world through the opportunities inherent to scholarship.
Service can be described in various ways. In the routine of the day's work, many opportunities arise to help others. Willingness to work for the benefit of those in need without monetary compensation or without recognition is the quality we seek in our membership. We are committed to the idea of volunteering our time and abilities to the creation of a better tomorrow.
Leadership should be exerted in a wholesome influence on the school, in taking the initiative in class and school activities. The real leader strives to train and aid others to attain the same objective. The price of leadership is sacrifice, the willing to yield one's personal interests for the interests of others. A leader has self-confidence and will go forward when others hesitate. No matter that power and resources many exist in the country, they are ineffectual without the guidance of a wise leader. Leadership is always needed. Thus, to lead is necessary for each of our members.
Character is the force within each individual which distinguishes that person from others. It gives each of us our individuality. It is that without which no one can respect oneself, nor hope to attain the respect of others. It is this force of character that guides one through life, and when once developed, grows steadily. Character is achieved and not received. It is a product of constant action, striving daily to make the right choice. The problem of character is the problem of self-control. We must be in reality what we wish to appear to others. By demonstrating such qualities as respect, responsibility, trustworthiness, fairness, caring, and citizenship, we may hope to prove by example that we value character. Is a candle that unites the ideals of each pillar of National Honor Society. Knowledge, service, leadership, and character intertwine to bond together all of these ideals and are represented by the fifth candle.
Very differing opinions on an intimate gathering. This is actually a large gathering. But I'm excited to be here, and I just want to take a minute to congratulate all of you. I went over a little bit of the paperwork that I received from Mr. Hartwell on the requirements to be here tonight, and you guys have all done a lot of work to earn your seats, so that's pretty commendable, and I just want to congratulate you. I'm just going to talk a little bit about, I wish you guys can't see the pictures that are playing over there, can you? Nope. Okay, I'm going to talk a little bit about the project that I started this last year. There are national organizations that offer the service that I do, but this is something that really tugged at my own heart and kind of pushed me to do what I'm doing. So I guess that's what I'm talking to you guys about tonight, is just the connection between your heart and your brains. Obviously, you've got all this great stuff going on intellectually and I'm sure emotionally, but I just wanted to job in that way. So I asked probably about 4 months ago if I would be interested in coming to a hospital and photographing a baby that was very, very ill. And I said no at the time. I didn't feel confident in my photography skills in different lighting situations, and I wasn't really sure emotionally how I would be able to handle a situation like that. So I said no at the time, and probably about a month later, I got another call, and they said, we need you tomorrow morning for a family that is going to be losing a child. They have no other opportunities of anyone to provide this service for them. And I just said yes. I followed my heart. I went, and I showed up, and I have to tell you, it was the most life-changing thing that's ever happened to me. Being able to be with people in their rawest moment and to be able to document for them that time is something that I can't really explain how emotional it is to be there, but it really opened up my view of what it meant to provide a service in our community, more than just a national organization or a big typical fundraiser. This is just something that I chose to do and continue to do. Recently, on the latest photo shoot that I've been to at the hospital, the family was really unprepared for the loss that they had and did not have an outfit for their baby at the time that he passed. And they have a closet at the hospital that was that has some extra clothing in it, and when they went to it, it was bare. So they didn't have anything to offer this family. So what I did is, over the summer, I decided that we would have a baby shower at our house. And literally, this is like how natural it was. It didn't cost a lot of money to have everybody show up at our house. I put an ad on Facebook and invited a bunch of friends, and I ended up getting outfits sent to me from all over the country with letters, emotional letters, and emails from families that had experienced losses everywhere. And we ended up with 500 outfits. So we were able to provide 500 outfits for all the local hospitals. I ended up going around and kind of spreading it out because it was way more than we had ever anticipated getting. So I guess when Mr. Harwell asked me to speak, that was kind of what I had in mind, is that I'm just encouraging you to look outside of the obvious ways to donate your time and your heart, and think about ways that are bigger and outside the box, I guess. I wish that you guys could see the video over there so you could see. There is a little girl. Most of the photos are in black and white. There is a little girl that will show up at some point who is in color, and she is, her name is Daniela. And I was asked to photograph her the night before she left for a liver transplant. She was on a waiting list for quite some time. So she's actually in color in here. And yes, I do know about white balance, but she is extremely orange in her picture, as she that she actually received a piece of a liver from a high school student. So you can donate a piece of your liver, and it regenerates in yourself and then creates a new liver for a baby. So she was saved, her life was saved. She's doing really, really well now. I continue to see her and photograph her. And the teenager that donated her liver, it's kind of interesting. She has two siblings, and so she completed that all three of them had actually donated. So I promised Danielle's mom that I would bring that up because it's not something I knew about, that we could do that. And then also, I brought along my little godson, Will, and he's gonna be my little token prop tonight. Will, and Will was a very, very high-risk pregnancy, and Will was not expected to be here with us at all. So there's Daniela, you can see her up there. Will, yeah, he was not expected to be with us. So when my friend Carrie went to New Jersey to deliver Will, he's got a lot to say. I ended up driving to New Jersey in the middle of a blizzard to photograph him when he was in the NICU because we just weren't sure that he was going to be with us. So I wanted to bring him along tonight, and his mom was nice enough to bring him out after he had his shots this morning, and it's way past his bedtime. But I thought he would be a really good example of why these things are so important, why it's really, really important to leave with your heart. I know you guys are all being told to leave with your brain and all this smart stuff, but I'm here to tell you to not forget your heart, because there's so much joy in that. So that's why we're here.
Vanessa Smith. Logan Stalter, who couldn't be with us tonight. Corey Stein. Benjamin Suriani. Alana Surowick. Alexandra Surowick. Okay, say it along with me. I pledge to maintain my high academic standing, to hold as fundamental and worthy an untarnished character, to endeavor intelligently and courageously to be a leader, and to give myself freely in the service of others. In doing so, I shall prove myself worthy of a place in the National Honor Society. Congratulations and welcome.